right, we're a little change of pace here. We're now over to the number 20 mini stock for the Putter Putt winner. This is Tammy Patterson, and we change trophy delivery jobs. This is Chris Hughes.
Yeah.
We're calling the trophy man.
Over at the pit shed, also they'll have the old there.
Tammy receives, oh, she's got some pretty flowers down there along with her trophy. And that's her husband, Jim Patterson. Second place point runner this year. I think we're missing. Barbara Williams run the Papa Pup in the 600s, and I think the Williams family has loaded everything up and gone on down the road. So our congratulations once again to all our winners, and a final thank you to everybody concerned with Delta Speedway for the 1996 season. This will be the 25-lap 600 Malta Sprint Division main event, and these should be the regular normal season drivers I'm about to introduce. At the back of the pack, your quick time tonight, second time at the track for the 96 season, comes to us out of Riverbank, the 69S. Welcome Scott Silva. We move up from him, out of Tracy, California, car number 75, Ken Rhines. Down below on the inside, car number 94, out of Merced, a youngster about 14 years of age, Dennis Crum. On the outside, front row, pole position, car number 93 out of Merced, young Stephen Williams. And on the pole position, car number 30, finished a strong third in points at Delta this year. Welcome Mr. Nice Guy out of Ripon, Tony Carey. Turn him loose. Lights out. Five cars, 25 laps. John Morley looking at it. Carey. Second place to the 93 out of Merced, Stephen Williams. Third place to the number 75 ride out of Tracy, Ken Rhines. Fourth place, car number 69, Scott Silva, rounding out your field at 94, Dennis Grom. Inside pole position, car number 30 out of Ripon, Brandon Carey. Next to him, car number 50, the track champion for the 96 season out of Manteca, Ryan Philpott. Ryan moved away on me as soon as I dropped my eyes. I think I know where he's going to go. 97 car being driven tonight by Jesse Craven. There's the 9 car, regular driver in it, Stockton driver Calvin King. And the 0 car out of Stockton, Mike Brooks Jr. And at the back of the pack, the 93 car, brand new driver, first time out, James Carpenter. All right, lights out. We anticipate a green flag when they come through the corner over there. Mark looks them over. Here they come. And he throws them a green. Philpott makes a clean move to the inside to sweep up to that number 2 spot. He's looking to the inside. Edges it in there, brings it around, brings it all the way from about 4th in line to lead lap number 1. Brandon Carey in the 2nd slot and losing ground by the look of it. Jesse Craven, number 3 in the 97 car. Afterburners on the number 50 ride, moving away from the pack. A little action back here between Calvin King. He slides by to the inside of Jesse Craven. Shows her what the tires look like at that rate of speed down the back straightaway. Jesse tries to hold even with him. King with the advantage off of turn 4. Mainly moves into the number 3 position. In the 0 car is pulled up there playing a little bumper tag with Jesse. We're letting him know he's there. And the 50 of Philpott, meanwhile, caught up in lap traffic. First time driver, number 93, James Carpenter. Philpott elects to move to the outside. Sweeps by cleanly. Straightaway, white flag in his face, final time around. Car out of Manteca, Ryan Philpott. Second to the 30, Brandon Carey. Third place, the 9 car of Calvin King. Fourth to the 97 of Jesse Craven. Fifth to the 0 of Mike Brooks Jr. Rounding out your field, the 93 of James Carpenter. Jimmy Griffiths out of Stockton. The 59 car driving it tonight is Dad Grant. That's Steve Grant. The 89 car driven by Bob Gilligan. The 2 car driven by Eldon Coots. The 70 car being driven by Charles Pereira. Being driven by Jamie Carpenter. Comes the 79 with Casey Tennant at the wheel. tells the drivers, okay guys, he turns off the yellow light. We anticipate the green flag as they move down the back straightaway into turns 3 and 4, and they come around to the flag stand. They're fairly even. Turn them loose. Here we come. Fender slapping already. Three wide off the corner. Everybody gets super. I'm having trouble with all the different names I've got tonight. Winner in the two car, Elvin Goetz, 93 car, Jamie Carpenter running second. The 70 car that I've been calling as Jim Patterson all night is Charles Pereira once again. I'll get this right before the night's over. And the 79, Casey Tinnen, those are your top four in the semi-main. They collect the transfer tickets. They will start at the back of the regular driver's main event for the mini stock division. Renee Carey, 75 should have Tammy Rhines behind the wheel. The 16 should be Rebecca Beard. And the Powder Puff event is set for 15 laps. Rebecca Beard over there, drove it right straight off that corner up into the wall. Got a green light, we got a green flag. Margaret says, bye-bye, I'm gone. for number four, Sam Solari. The seven car. Get my list lined up here right where I can see what I'm talking about. Seven car driven by Billy Rhodes. Ten car lower inside, Angelo Corleone. 33 of Darwin Davis. The two of Eldon Coates. The 61 of Rod Moore. The 93 of Jamie Carpenter. The eight car David Blair. 14, Dave Bunn. The 70 car, Charles Pereira. Got it right that time. The 28 car, Bill Simmons behind the wheel. Bill Simmons in the 28 car tonight. 79 car, setting over by itself. Turn number four, Casey Tinnen. Duties. He's got the yellow light off. They go down the back straight away through the corners. We'll see if we can get a green. For the 14 of Dave Bunn driving that car tonight. He's turned around by the number 8 car of David Blair over in the middle of 1 and 2 over there. Six down, six laps down on a 20 lap minimum. Thank you. for the 45 of Alan Cole. Last race of the season, got all the way to the mix-up. Here they come, right side. French camp, number 33, Darwin Davis. Running fourth, car number 79, out of Manteca, Casey Tinnen. And your fifth place finisher, car number 44, out of San Jose, Rick Crisafulli. Necessarily in starting order, we've got the 0 of Mike Brooks Jr., the 9 of Calvin King, the 30 of Brandon Carey, the 50 of Ryan Philpott, the 93 of James Carpenter, the 97 of Jesse Kramer. It looks like the 9, Calvin King, on the inside. Here they come off the corner. We got a green. Brandon Carey jumps to the outside down the back stretch. Philpott coming up from the back again. Here they come off the corner. Carey will get credit for that first lap. Philpott working him strong in that second spot. King slides back in position number 3. Oh, they get tangled up off the corner, up onto that berm. They get hung up. And we're going to get a yellow. Two laps down, scheduled for 15 laps. Here they come, green's out. Whoa, little contact, right on the start. 30 of Brandon Carey faced in the wrong direction immediately. Out. Here they come. Mark says, go get it, guys. And young Brooksy up on the outside can't make it work. Goes in behind. Meanwhile, Philpott trying to figure out a way around the both of them. Whoa! And they slide, and everybody goes bang, bang, bang. And another yellow. Okay, here we go. Lights out. 3 down. Around the corner they come. Calvin King brings them in. Green flags out. Brandon Carey makes a move around the outside. And takes over the lead. Bill Botten runs with him into second place. Phil Potts got the inside look as he comes through 3 and 4. And he takes over the lead on lap number 5. Philpott, Carey, and a dead heat between King and Brooks as they battle side by side. Brooks comes around and takes over that third spot. And young Michael Brooks made up the ground on the 30 of Carey. We may have a battle for that second position before too long. Car, the 1996 division champion out of Manteca, Ryan Philpott. Running second in car number 30 out of Ripon, Brandon Carey. In the third spot, the zero car out of Stockton, Mike Brooks Jr. Finishing fourth, car number 9 out of Stockton, Calvin King. Running fifth, car number 93 in his first night out, James Carpenter. And your sixth and final spot for the main event, car number 97, Jesse Craven. On the inside front row, then the pumpkin car with Kathy Cook outside of her. Second row inside, Tammy Patterson. And Michelle Lahman, your third row in the 62-14 combination cars. That would be Tammy Surrett on the inside and Star Brooks on the outside. The fourth row, the 45 and the 32 combination. The 45 would be Carolyn Beck. The 32, Linda Abernathy. Bobby Gilligan. 93 of Deborah Carpenter would make up the next row. Alright, hold on to your seats. Lights out. Mark Vincelet looking them over.
Look out, there you go, don't take it down, there you go, you're all right, back on the bells, back on the bells.
Captain Cook makes a move on the outside in the pumpkin car. They battle up to the number four. And Captain takes control at the yellow. We've got the 45 of Carolyn Beck and the 28. Michelle Lawman tied up back there just off of turn number two. That's the cause for the yellow flag. Two laps down, two down. Lights out. They pick it up as they come down the back straightaway. Off of turn number four. Now the flag stays. For the pumpkin car. Lights out. Here they come. Speed's up. We're down. Scorers right up the wall over here. Your winner, unless told otherwise, in the 20 car out of Stockton, Tammy Patterson. I'm going to have to remain strictly unofficial at this point with the 28 car, Michelle Lauman, in second, the 45 of Carol Beck in third, the 93 of Deborah Carpenter fourth. Scoring once again, the 61 of Tammy Westheim is who I had fifth. Now any one of those girls could be a lap down, so do not take that as an official finish. Scoring will have to recap the event to make sure that the 79 of Dana Tinnant, leading from lap 1 to lap 14, spinning around over there, Tammy Patterson grabs that win for sure. Race for the 600 250s. Shows you how much I know, or how much I'm informed, put it that way. It told me it was being canceled. Doesn't look like it, huh? Well, according to my listing, the 75, the 600 is Jim Rhines. On the backstretch, the push start is Jesse Van Kol, V-A-N-K-O-L. And in the 30 car, Greg Wilson. If I was a motorcycle, would be concerned the most. You see those on the scrambler type bikes and smaller road bikes. Van Kol in the lead down the back straightaway in the 250. Greg Wilson in second place. Jim Rhines. Thank you. for second spot. Pilser behind the wheel. The 70 car, Rick Perkins. Not Charles Pereira, Rick Perkins. Let me get this right. Had that one messed up all night. Here you go, Ron McCall in the 10 car. Rick's on, lights off, flag man's looking. The medal of the medal immediately. It under control, just touches that back end of that car to that fence a little bit. And the 8-car Pilcher trying to get by, rips his own people inside. As the 2-car of Eldon Coots becomes a momentary barrier to him. Woods with a problem over here in turn number four. and run, bump and run. Everybody's okay. Swing them high, swing them low. Hold on. Pointed every direction. Number 70, Rick Perkins. Running second in the 10th car, Ron McCall. Third to the driver of car number 8, Roger Pilcher. And your fourth car on the track, the 2 car, Eldon Kuntz. And we lost the 9 car, that would have been the 5th place car, Mike Woods. As we work on the lineup, I'll give you the names in the numerical order that I've got them. The pumpkin car, if it comes up, Mike Ricketts. The 2 is Eldon Kuntz. The 6 is Jerry Solari. The 8 is Roger Pilcher. 9, Mike Woods. 14, Dave Bunn. 20, Mike Davis. 28, Bob Silvey. 32, Manny Newstead. 45, Alan Cole. 59, Steve Grant. 61, Danny Gabor. 70, Rick Perkins. 79, Forrest Souza. 89, Matt Cable. 93, Michael Han. 7, Billy Rose. And 10, Ron McCall. The 45 of Alan Cole once again. We got a green. Oh, these guys are out for blood. Look at the speed we're developing down here. These guys are cooking. And the 6 of Jerry Solari takes the lead. I think we got some ringers in here. These don't look like mechanics. They're moving on. And the 6 of Jerry Solari gets it loose on the front straightaway, loses the lead to the 45 of Alan Cole. Forrest Souza. That's a mouthful. Runs in the 3rd slot. Oh-ho, trading paint. Look out, got the 32 car pointed the wrong way. He's all right. And he stalls it out. Yellow comes out. Oh, the 61 is a rear bumper tag. Danny Gabor goes up there and says, let's bend this front end a little bit more.
go. Lights out. Five down. Ready for a green. And we got it. We're gone. We're racing. See ya.